A personal brand is exactly how it sounds. It's a brand built around a person as opposed to a business entity. And when someone becomes the go-to person for a certain topic or niche or thing, then they can use that audience they've built to leverage for so many opportunities in their field. That can mean more products sold for your business, more marketing opportunities as an influencer, that publishing deal you want as a writer, that record deal you want as a musician. Your personal brand will let people know who you are and how you bring value. So in this video, I'm giving you 5 tips you need as a foundation to build an effective online personal brand right after this intro. Ooh, I'm a pretty man. Ooh, that's an ugly style. The first tip on this list is to lock in your niche, aka your topic of expertise. It's really hard to build a personal brand if you're not a go-to person for something. For instance, Jerry Lorenzo, one of the top designers of high-end men's streetwear. You might know him best for his brand, Fear of God. But what you might not know is that he used to be a stylist of celebrities back in the day. So once he built up his clout as being associated with bigger names than him, styling certain people, it was a no-brainer for him to start his own company. He already brought a lot of people value through the fact that he was able to dress people that people liked. So when the stylist that's well known, that's already proven his worth and his value, drops a clothing line, of course you're gonna buy it, and that's one of the reasons why he blew up. And even for me as a digital strategist and marketing coach, what better way to prove my credibility than to do it for myself first? Out of the 120 videos I have here on YouTube, half of them is teaching you exactly what people hire me for, and that's to help them communicate their value online and build brands. The second tip on this list is to be authentic. Be real, be yourself. I think oftentimes when we see people that are really successful at what we want to be successful at, it's really easy to just like copy what they do, copy how they say something or like their channel intro or the format for their podcast, because that's so much less effort than actually embracing your own flaws and putting your real self out there. That's a really scary place to be, so I do not blame you. But I'm telling you, that is the place where you're gonna find most of your power and the most community support. For example, one of my biggest insecurities is my belly. I'm about 30 to 40 pounds overweight right now. I've been too lazy to go to the gym. I have not been eating right. And since the other half of my channel is about men's fashion, I made a video about how to dress around a dad bod so people can't really tell how you look underneath your clothes. So you actually feel confident, you can go about your life with your shoulders back. And I'm telling you right now, it's one of my highest viewed videos ever. It's like almost 500,000 views right now. So if you really embrace who you are, your flaws, your quirks, all the things you don't like about yourself, I promise you, there are people out there just like you looking for your specific message that only you can bring. The third tip on this list is to be consistent. Now, we're not just talking about posting regularly on social media, but also being consistent in your aesthetic and in your messaging. Your messaging is your topic of discussion. Again, what do you want to be known about? If you want to be known for being a dope comedian, maybe Instagram is like all your funny skits. Facebook, those same skits, maybe a little bit shorter in a different format. And then maybe on Twitter, you tell jokes, right? And then on your YouTube, maybe you teach people how to tell jokes, how to set up a punchline. Those all go together. If you have a random account about puppies and dogs, that completely distracts from everything you're trying to build. Now, if you love puppies and dogs, make a separate account and make sure nobody knows that you, as the brand you're trying to build, is attached to it, because it ain't got nothing to do with your brand necessarily if you're the comedian person from my example. So you get what I'm saying. Messaging, aesthetic, consistent. Now, before I move on to these last two tips and the best ones on this list, if you're still watching this video and you haven't subbed to my channel yet, you probably want to do that. Here I talk about how to create better content, how to be more successful on social media, and how to present yourself better online. The other side of my channel, I teach you how to present yourself better in real life. Everything from how to dress better, how to smell better, and how to have more confidence. So if that sounds good to you, hit that subscribe button, hit that bell icon, and every time I drop a video, you'll be notified. Number four, choose the platform or platforms that are best for you. So just because a person you look up to is really good on Instagram, really good on LinkedIn, really good on Facebook, doesn't necessarily mean those are the best platforms for you. If you're really great at talking but you don't want to be on camera, you should probably be doing a podcast, right? If you love styling clothing but maybe you do not want to make videos, maybe it should be just amazing photos. If you're good at being on camera like I am and you don't mind talking, then this is what you want to do. Now for me personally, I was on Instagram for 3 years before I ever started a YouTube channel. And that's one of the things that I really look back like, man, I should have started a YouTube channel way back then because I enjoy YouTube so much more. I really thrive here. I love this community. I love you guys. You've grown so much together and I should have started this a long time ago. So don't be like me. Go with your strength as opposed to what everybody else is doing in your space, and that's where you'll find success. Now, last but not least on this list, number 5 is the most important tip, and that is to bring people value. And another way to put that is to give your best stuff away for free. Think about the comedians you know that started on Vine or Instagram and how big they are now. You got the Jake Pauls, you got the King Batches, you got Ha Ha Davis, you got the Shiggy Show, right? All these people started on Instagram and now they're in music videos, they're on TV, they're doing comedy tours, all the things they love because they have your trust, people know them, they have an audience around being funny. So of course, they're gonna open up doors for themselves to do those things. Well, that's all I got for y'all in this video. I wanted to make this quick and digestible. If you have any more questions about personal branding, leave them down in the comments. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video and you haven't subbed to my channel yet, make it happen. Thank you so much for your time and I will see you on the next one. Peace.